Hi everyone, this is Fariba from watchknitting.com, and today in this video I will be showing how to make convertible mittens. To make the video easy for uploading, I divided the entire video into 5 parts, and this one is the part 1, and I will be working on cuff and palm loop of the glove until thumb marking line. Okay, let's have a look at the materials you need. You need a medium size yarn or number 4 in US sizing. The wool yarns will have better results. I'm using Nako from Turkey, as the label says the needle for this yarn would be 4.5 or 5 millimeters. But if I go with those sizes, I have to cast on a smaller number of stitches, and then I will not have enough stitches for fingers. So what I will do, I will use number 2.5 millimeter needles, which is number 3 in US sizing, and I'm gonna get help from another spare needle only for dividing stitches. You also need a pair of scissors, a piece of scrap yarn, a large eye blunt needle, a big safety pin or a stitch holder, a measuring tape, and some buttons. The given size for this tutorial is a small, and I will cast on 48 stitches. I consider half an inch per stitch plus 3 inch extra for tail for long tail casting on. Then I cast on 48 stitches. For any size larger than small, you will need to add multiple of 8 stitches to that 48 stitch. For example, if you want to go one size larger, you need to cast on 56 stitches. And then you're gonna prorate that extra stitches on your fingers. The direction of making gloves is from cuff to fingers. So any kind of rib stitch could be worked for cuff. I'm doing mine as knit to purl 2, and I'm gonna repeat this until my piece measures 3 inches from cast on edge. Next, I will be working on the body and creating the loop. At this point, I'm gonna get my third needle and divide my stitches into 2 equal parts by sliding 24 stitches from left needle to the spare needle. Now you need to fold it in half and get the other needle and slip 1 stitch at a time from each needle in the left hand to the right hand, alternately starting from front needle. This is important to remember which needle you slipped your first stitch from, because in the following rows your instruction will rely on that stitch. If you get the first stitch from the front needle, like what I did, then in following rows your instruction will be repeating knit 1 slip 1 for all following rows. But if you slip the first stitch from the back needle, then your instruction for following rows will be repeating slip 1 knit 1 instead of knit 1 slip 1. Okay, now I'm gonna take a look at inside the stitches. You always should have this order of stitches after this to have your loop working. As you see, my first stitch is free, it's not connected to working yarn. I'm gonna insert my tip of needle to that stitch and then grab the string from the second stitch in row and knit it. Then you're gonna move your string to the front and slip the second stitch. Again, move the yarn to the back and knit one stitch. It is very important to remember to move your working yarn between stitches while you are doing slip one, knit one. Otherwise, your loop will be blocked. Also, I want to highlight that you can do your own way of doing knit stitch, and it does not change your result. I find it easy to do knit stitch through back loop instead of front loop. Also, I twist the stitches as I slip them, because it will make it easier for me to knit them in the next row. You need to repeat knitting knit one slip one until your piece measures 2.5 inch, and then in the next video I will show you how to mark the thumb line. Enjoy the rest of the day for now, and see you in the next tutorial.